Dorsey's orchestra with Frank Sinatra's vocal. But this is a great version of Blue Skies. I think you'll like it very much. Blue Skies.
Oh, about a song. It's a...
I'm just looking for my friends right now. So I'm and he was playing with bass and stuff like this.
Right.
And that was his focus.
But he had a lot
of people who come out of the studio.
Say, what was it like being up there, you know, up there in the country?
Yeah, I'm looking down here, and it's not really well, and it's, you know, you realize when you're up there looking down, you see the earth so small, you realize how really insignificant everybody is, you know, there's, and he went on like this for, I'd say, a good 10 minutes, and, you know, people were enjoying, Les was like totally blown away by all the things that he was saying about being up there. And so when Scott finished, Mr. Carpenter, I guess you should be calling him, Les looks at me and he says, "That's Scott Carpenter." He says, "Don't you have anything to say to him?" And I picked up the microphone and I said,
"The one guy.
I was sorry to hear about Karen." And at least you people, I got a lot of looks like that too. People looked at me like, what is he talking about? Because I'm just thinking music all the time, you know.
That's true. That
and another person, we talked about this story earlier tonight, Henny Youngman was also a great guy who came in. And it was so wonderful to see Henny Youngman and Les, who was very quick-witted, very sharp-witted, trading, I'll call them insults, but you know, they really weren't. Bars, I guess, back and forth, one right another. These two guys of the same generation era, and it was just like wonderful to see like this, these two guys like going at it like that. It was really quite incredible.
Yeah, 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 yeah. look at some clocks real quick.
Okay.
Oh, low grand, probably just clocks.
Do you know what time it is?
No.
You should
have
cuckoo clocks on
here. Cuckoo clocks are my least favorite. My favorite are these right here. Ground colors. They creep me out when that thing pops out, the bird. I used to have one, my grandma used to have one. Sometimes it gets stuck and keep chirping, especially in the middle of the night.
Oh, really?
It'll pop out and keep chirping. I love grandfather's clocks.
Pardon?
I love grandfather's clocks. My grandma and grandpa used to have one. Love to hear when they chime and stuff. Such a peaceful sound. Pecker episode when that one guy worked the clock back and got went crazy because they all rang at some time. These things are expensive.
I'm also not this
one. Oh yeah. A couple of these are off by a couple of hours. This one's way off.
Did you know Shane works at Pick and Save also?
Yep.
Did you try it?
Mm-hmm. I've seen him a few times.
Oh, really?
I actually shopped there a couple times.
Where?
Just in case you don't know, this is my friend Dusty Lockerbie. Been friends since elementary school.
Hi!
There's Winnie the Pooh. There's Winnie the Pooh. Winnie the Pooh lives here.
I'm gonna hang out with my friends now.
Okay. I'll still be around here somewhere.
I see his column every day.
The Friday Night Live today.
I don't know how live it is.
Mm-hmm. I think the big stand, big stage just got done. I'll be able to start out. There's. Back down this way. Try and get some.
Mm-hmm. Hi.
cool.
Good.
Good turnout, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Is this going to be on YouTube anytime soon?
Tomorrow. Library's closed, so I have to wait till tomorrow.
So how long have you been doing that for?
A year.
You've been doing this for a year now?
Yep. Hello, Dusty. How are you doing? Welcome to YouTube.
I'm making a...
This is your first YouTube video.
This is me taking a beer.
Oh, you got sick. Later on. I plan to come here later and get some hot wings.
What's he doing?
They're almost like the Beatles, but like a hometown version. They play Beatles songs.
Am I coming on the YouTube page?
Yeah, tomorrow.
Good. I want my pure time back. I want my pure time back.
That place down there has really good hot wings, that old style place.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I don't like them too hot, not too spicy, just right.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Have you been to Starbucks? I mean,
last year.
Last year?
Yeah, they had a really good sandwich, too. There's People's Park, they get a good hamburger. Mm-hmm. So you're here with your friends?
What?
You're here with your other friends?
I'm Will Chocolate. This is Chad James and Mike Westendorf. Popping and rocking on stage with the No Defenders. Niels is going to have Peter DeMoor and the Steaming Cup, Barefoot, Jeans, and Magellan's The Lonely Hearts.
Videotaping.
So there's a lot of talent. There's a lot of talent that came from this town. Some in musical.
Just make sure you say that.
Exhibit and our new community health center, which will be here in downtown Waukesha. Together, we are amplifying the vibrancy of our community. Together, we are amplifying the vibrancy of small town America right here in Waukesha. Now, it's my privilege to welcome another special guest from the Wisconsin Department of Tourism. Please join me in welcoming David Spiegelberg.
Thank you, Mayor, and congratulations, Waukesha. Secretary of Tourism Stephanie Klett and Deputy Secretary Dave Fantle were here last night to enjoy the activities, and we just want to thank you for your invitation last night. They apologize that they couldn't be here today, but I do have a prepared statement from the Department of Tourism that I would like to share with you. So once again, congratulations, Waukesha. On behalf of the Wisconsin Department of Tourism, I would like to extend a sincere congratulations to the city of Waukesha on your designation as an official Gibson Guitar Town. How appropriate that Gibson Guitars chose the birth and resting place of guitar legend Les Paul for its next acclaimed Guitar Town public art project. Waukesha is known for its growing art and music scene and beautifully restored downtown. These beautifully painted guitars will serve as one more reason for tourists and residents alike to enjoy all that Waukesha and the surrounding area has to offer. The Guitar Town project will help unite Waukesha's music, art, business, and tourism community, and the guitars and the Les Paul heritage in Waukesha only strengthens Wisconsin's status as the premier destination in the Midwest for all things fun. So, please enjoy your newly acclaimed and well-deserved designation. Enjoy the gifted work of the artists with the guitars, and enjoy your evening and music fun tonight. And I believe that I am going to officially count down the unveiling of the 10 guitars that you see around you. So if you would join me in the countdown, and since we have 10 guitars, why don't we start with 10? So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Enjoy the guitars and enjoy your evening. Thank you, everybody. Congratulations, Waukesha.
The left call duo because we're running a little early. So just don't go away. Painted Les Pauls.
He has work on sale in the Allmark Gallery down on the
okay. These are the people, the three people who played with Les Paul at the arena. These are the people. But yes, come on. These are not just musicians from New York. These are legends.
Where did you
play with them? And all the other legends that are on stage.
We're going to go look at this one because it's
artists.
Okay.
They played last night and they were rocking the house. And so we're very pleased to have them here. Logan, you're ready to go. Lou Paul, and the rest of the
look at the guitars and then look at
the sick in the front, follow on the back.
Thank you.
dance and hunger. Dinner ready. She loves the theater. Never comes late. She never bothers.
Thank you. Thank you. Ooh. Thank you. right. And then what once was tight unbounds a dangerous love. I can see it in your eyes, a dangerous love. It's full of alibis, a dangerous love. No one here gets out alive, a dangerous love. I can see it in your dangerous love. I can see it in your eyes, a dangerous love. It's full of alibi, a dangerous love.
John Coniani. Gary Mazzarotti, your three little brothers. Thank you very much.
That's how we used to listen to music.
See you again soon. Thank you.
Isn't that weird? You had to actually put the record on a machine and start the machine to make it make music.
So here for the last fall trio, everybody.
You are so kind, really. We're not even prepared for something like this. We haven't had this in a long time, right?
Yes, I think so. And I'm going to have John announce this one for you. It's an arrangement that he'll announce.
Okay. We would like to do a number. This arrangement was written by Les Paul himself for his early trio back in around 1942. And he recorded this song, Irving Berlin's song, Blue Skies. Well, you're going to hear it. He recorded this with his original trio for Decca Records. And he had a kind of a hit on it, but the hit was kind of outsold by quite a big margin by the version by Tommy Dorsey's orchestra with Frank Sinatra's vocal. But this is a great version of Blue Skies. I think you'll like it very much. Blue Skies.
Please don't go away just yet.